In the first stage, prior to meiosis, thin strands of DNA in the cell nucleus thicken into chromosomes, which then duplicate themselves. In early prophase, the centrioles divide and with the asters move apart. The nuclear membrane begins to disintegrate. In the third stage, in late prophase, the centrioles and asters are at opposite poles, and the nucleus and nuclear membrane have almost disappeared. In the fourth stage, the double chromosomes, their centromeres attached to the spindle fibers, line up at mid-cell in the metaphase. In early anaphase, the centrosomes split. Half the chromosomes move to one pole, half to the other pole. In late anaphase, the chromosomes have almost reached their respective poles. The cell membrane begins to pinch at the center. In the seventh stage, the cell membrane completes constriction in telophase, nuclear membranes from around the separated chromosomes. And last but not least, mitosis completed. There are two cells with the same structures and number of chromosomes as the parent. At the onset of meiosis, DNA strands thicken into chromosomes. Homologous, or like chromosomes, begin to approach each other. Homologous chromosomes are to form bivalents. The centrioles divide and move to opposite poles of the cell. The bivalents duplicate to form tetrads, or four chromatid groups. The nuclear membrane disintegrates, crossing over, recombination occurs. In metaphase I, the tetrads attached to the spindle fibers at their chromomeres line up at the mid-cell. In early anaphase I, the tetrads separate and the paired chromatids have moved along the spindles to their respective centrioles. In late anaphase I, the chromatids have almost reached the spindle poles. The membrane begins to constrict. In telophase I, nuclear membranes enclose the separated chromatids. The cell membrane completes its constriction. The first meiotic division ends. There are now two cells, each with the same number of chromatids as the parent cell. Prophase II begins in the second meiotic division. Homologous chromatids do not duplicate but merely separate. In metaphase II, the chromatids line up at the mid-cell. The centrioles and asters are the poles. A spindle has formed. In anaphase II, the now separated chromatids approach their respective poles. The cell membrane begins to constrict. Telophase II has completed. There are now four cells, each with half the number of chromosomes of the parent cell.